R. Allen Stanford is not shy about flaunting his wealth. In November, he paid $20 million to stage a cricket championship on the Caribbean island of Antigua, publicly with the prize money.
Half of the Stanford Financial Group.
Just 3 months before, he hobnobbed with top Democrats in Denver as the lead sponsor of the National Democratic Institute Conference.
I'd like to thank the Stanford Financial Group.
Since 2000, Stanford has funneled $1.7 million to politicians, $4,600 last year to President Obama's campaign.
Y'all move back.
But today, federal agents raided Stanford's offices in Memphis and Houston and froze the assets of three of his companies, accusing Stanford and two others of massive ongoing fraud, of selling customized certificates of deposit, promising interest rates that are improbable, if not impossible. Officials say Stanford lost some of his clients' money in the Bernie Madoff Ponzi scheme, and overall may have bilked up to $8 billion from investors like Brett Zigone.
My mom just passed away a few months ago. All of the money from her estate is here. My brother and I was executor of the estate. I have money from my sister and brother in here, and that's why I'm here.
Stanford's financial empire has a global reach with offices in Montreal, Zurich, and Antigua, with 50,000 clients in 131 countries. And his sponsorship of high-profile golf tournaments and golfers has spread his brand. But James Dunlap, who represents a number of Stanford investors, says the fraud fallout is also global.
I'm getting calls from people who have lost from as little as $100,000 to north of $10 million.
Stanford has not been arrested and does not yet face criminal charges. His company is refusing all comments, but his clients have plenty of questions. Number one, will they ever see their money? Bob Orr, CBS News, Washington.